But the curious thing is that not one of the same can be brought to acknowledge his family name, for never a grumbler will own that he is connected with it all, you see. The worst thing is that if anyone stays among them too long, he will learn their ways, and before he dreams of the terrible jumble, he is adopted into the family of grumble. Students, in this video we will see the explanation of the next two stanzas. See, in the first stanza of this section, very first line says that, but the curious thing is that not one of the same can be brought to acknowledge his family name. To understand these two lines, we have to know the meanings for two words. One is curious. Curious means strange, different. And in the next line, you have the meaning for the word acknowledge. Acknowledge means accept, accepting, admitting something. What does the poet say in these two lines? The nature of the grumblers, they were discussed in the previous stanzas. What we have discussed so far, they complain about everything, they complain about nature, even the place they live, it is full of complaining. Their inborn nature is complaining, blaming, finding fault. These are the things with grumblers. But how they behave to others, they will not accept that they are grumblers. They have the quality and the nature of complaining, but in fact, to explain the truth, they will say that I am not complaining, I am not finding fault. So in this way, they don't accept that they belong to the family of grumblers. It is nature. See, if somebody does any mistake, he will not accept that he did any mistake. No criminal will accept that he is a criminal. It is nature. Like that, the grumblers will not accept that they belong to family of grumblers. They try to show that they are positive thinkers and normal people. Then, for never a grumbler will own that he is connected with it all, you see. Poet tells openly that no grumbler will openly accept that he belongs to grumble family. And he tries to show himself to others that he is a positive thinker and a normal person. That is all told in this stanza. There was a couple, husband and a wife, newly married. During the sleep, only the wife found that her husband was a snorer, very good snorer. Snoring means, you know, some people will make sound, very bad sound, which arises from nose and mouth. It will not let others sleep. The husband is snoring throughout the night. Wife tries to wake the husband. Please wake up, don't snore, I cannot sleep. The husband calmed for 2 seconds. Once again, when the wife is sleeping, again the snoring sound disturbed her. Once again, she wakes her husband up. Dear, please don't snore, I cannot sleep. Like that, she wake up her husband for almost 10 times. The husband calmed for 2 minutes. Once again, snoring started up. This continued for one full night. Then the day dawned. In the morning, wife asked about the previous night's sleep to her husband. Last night you didn't let me sleep, you were snoring. I tried to wake you, but you continued your snoring. So I cannot sleep. What can I do about this? Husband told. Husband has some defect with him, he is snoring. But he tells, no, I don't know that you talk in sleep. You are talking in the sleep. So I think you have the disease of talking during the sleep. So the husband thought that the wife's waking up as a disease. In this way, he tries to hide his mistake. This is the quality of grumblers. They have quality of grumbling, but they will not accept it. So in this way we can know the quality of the grumblers. No grumbler will accept he is a grumbler. In the second stanza, very important one, how grumbling affects the good people. In the mind map we had discussed in one box, if you have contact with grumblers, even good people will be spoiled. That is the message of this stanza. The worst thing is that if anyone stays among them too long, he will learn their ways. Here the poetess gives a warning for readers. He tells, if we stay with more time, stay for more time with grumblers, even good people will become grumblers. They will know the habit of grumbling. They will learn the habit of finding fault from the complaining people. Like that, the poetess tells. And before he dreams of the terrible jumble, he is adopted into the family of grumble. This transformation, good people becoming into grumbler, this transformation will happen very quickly. It is called by the word jumble. Jumble means gathering. Good people gathered with grumblers, gathering. This change will happen very quickly. So he gives a warning to good people. If you have some friendship, if you contact with grumblers, be careful, you will be spoiled. So it is better that we should not have any contact with grumblers. In this way, we can safeguard ourselves. Thank you.